Thanks for staying with us. So we are still on the hashtag ENDSARS conversation. With us this morning is Korede Bello. He's a police youth ambassador.
Hi.
He spoke with the IGP yesterday, and he's going to be speaking with the IGP again today. Hello, Korede, in the building.
Yo, woo, yo, woo, yo.
Hi. Good morning.
I'm almost certain that when you became a youth ambassador, you never knew that this time would come where you'll be sought after to talk about the police.
Oh, no. It's a fragile situation to be in, because I'm a young person as well.
Right.
And I have experienced my own fair share of the situation at hand. So it's not interesting.
Right.
It's serious business. So yeah.
On both sides of the divide. Okay, so let's start with your conversation with the IGP yesterday.
Both sides of the divide.
In your view, they've said they've dissolved SARS, but young people still don't believe. In your view, what do you think is the best approach for the police to handle or address this issue out at hand?
So, they didn't say it has been dissolved. Fundamentally, there's a trust, there's an atmosphere, aura of distrust between the police and the people. It has always been there. So especially having, the repeated disbandment of the units over the past 4 years, it definitely, arouses the feeling of distrust in this new statement. But this time it is confirmed. There's so many things that the police or the government can do, but the most important thing is to show, not to say, what has or what hasn't been done. People need to see it, need to feel it. So while we were having the forum yesterday, there was a forum with National Human Rights Commission, some CSOs, and the presidential panel on the recommendations, both the five demands that we asked and the presidential, the recommendations by the presidential panel on the issue.
Is there any one or two things that the police is willing to do right away to calm the protesters?
Oh, right then I challenged the IG to tell the men to stop using live ammunition on peaceful protesters. Mm-hmm. It is not done. People are allowed to assemble, right to assembly. It's constitutional. So, a rubber bullet, whatever it is, but people should not be shot at.
So what is the IG's stand clearly on, those officers who are disobeying that order that he's given to his, and, are we likely to see not only them being, dismissed, but, prosecuted for those actions that they took?
Oh, absolutely. One of the demands that we're making is an for the Aryan officers to be tried openly, to face justice in an in a public forum, or a forum that is open to the public for everybody to know. So apparently, a lot of officers get dismissed and punished. They have an internal system that deals with this kind of stuff, but the people don't know. And that's what has been causing the tension. Like, the people need to see that, oh, this person acted up. I don't want to curse on TV, but this person, did this, and this is what we're going to do to the person. But people need to start, we need to have a public forum where people face justice, because they offended the public, and the public needs to, feel that justice happened.
What would you say to your young people on the street, having experienced the challenges the police officers are facing?
I don't want young people to feel like, oh, I'm going to speak on behalf of them. No, I'm not the official spokesperson of young people. This is an organic protest and organic yearning from young people across Nigeria. I'm in no position to speak for them. I am speaking for myself because I have experienced my fair share of police brutality. Please, let me just say this last thing. So I advocate for mental health. I personally believe that the stem of our problem is from mental health or mental illness. I believe that a lot of our leaders suffer from a form of mental illness. I believe that if we can address mental illness on a large scale and stop the stigma, we will see problems for what they really are. A lot of our actions and inactions are a result of the expressions of our internal environment. If we cannot get our internal environment right, we will keep making mistakes and keep curing symptoms. So these are just symptoms we're speaking about. But to start addressing our internal environment, we will not get the leadership that we seek. We will not end the culture of impunity, and we'll just be going round and round. So everybody, we need to amplify the message more to check in with what's going on in our head. A lot of people are crazy. A lot of leaders are, they're not good upstairs, and we let them. We don't have any psychological,
into the police.
Korede, I think we can let you go with that, because you've told us you are sitting in the environment of power. And you are confirming to us that many of our leaders, it's not correct up there.
Good morning, Yemi. Are you there?
Good morning. Now I can hear you.
Yes, yes. Good to have you on the show. Yemi, I said in my opening statement that we've heard from the president, we've heard from the IGP, they've dissolved SARS. Why are you still on the streets?
Well, very simply, the morning that they dissolved SARS, pretty much about an hour after, the police in Abuja were waterbombing, shooting live bullets and tear gassing protesters in Abuja. Hmm. So simply that their words and their actions don't align. Mm-hmm. So we need to see a clear proof of intent. That is not just an audio cancellation as they've done almost every year in the last 5 years.
All right, Yemi, I have to let you go, but just tell us the status of what's going on in Alausa right now. I know that you're converging there. Could you give us an idea what's going on right now?
People are coming, music is playing, people are holding posters, and the crowd is building up gradually.
What's the plan? Where are you walking from? From what point to what point? And what do you expect to see at the end of the day?
Now the key thing is we might just walk around Obafemi and come back, or stay here and just really talk, and we have a statement to present to Mr. Governor.
Okay.
He says he has an appointment with President Buhari at 3 o'clock this afternoon.
Okay.
So the idea is to present to him these things that I've just talked about. That, yeah, we hear you that you said it, but these are the things that we now show that you plan to implement.
Gotcha. Joining us on the show now is Mr. Gbenga Omotoso, Honorable Commissioner for Information, Lagos State. Good morning, sir. Are you there?
Good morning. I'm here.
Yes, good to have you on the show. Yes, so yesterday we saw the governor of Lagos State attending to protesters. Could you give us an idea what happened and how he was able to calm them yesterday?
Governor, first we'd like to sympathize with the families who lost their loved ones in this crisis. And he just felt taking no action was no option yesterday, and that he had to go and talk to the protesters to understand their feelings and to tell them that he was with them. And that was exactly what he did. He got there, it was a bit rowdy, and at the same time, it was not that bad for a situation like that, because it was not charged. Yeah, like the governor told them yesterday, their grievances are very well understood, and they are being looked into. The governor himself is going to meet the president today, and later he is going to meet the Inspector General of Police, and he's meeting various groups and assuring them that this matter will be put behind us, and that everything that the protesters are asking for will be taken care of.